Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for August to October 2018. The outlook is for mostly drier and warmer conditions than average. If El Niño develops, these conditions could continue beyond the outlook period. But first, let's look at recent conditions. It has been a very dry first half of the year, especially across much of eastern Australia. The Murray-Darling Basin had its driest January to June since 1986. July rainfall has also been mostly below average. This means soil moisture is also below average for much of Australia. While there may be some winter growth on the surface, soils are generally dry underneath. The clear skies and dry soils have led to some very cold nights, with extreme frosts for inland eastern Australia. Overnight temperatures in mid-July dipped to more than 6 degrees below average. However, the cloud-free days and low rainfall has also led to warmer than average maximum temperatures during July and for winter to date. We'd normally expect water storages across southern Australia to have started filling by now. We have seen overall increases in storage levels over the past month in the southern Murray-Darling Basin and southwest Western Australia. However, storages in the northern Murray-Darling Basin, southern Victoria, and eastern New South Wales continue to decline. So what's driving our climate right now? Climate patterns in the Pacific and Indian Oceans are currently neutral, so the outlook for rainfall and temperature is based on more local influences. Cooling waters to the north of Australia bring less tropical moisture, and weaker westerly winds to the south bring less cloud and fewer rain systems to the southeast. In addition, with a slow warming trend in the tropical Pacific Ocean and 5 of 8 climate models suggesting El Niño in spring, the Bureau's ENSO outlook remains at El Niño watch. During El Niño, rainfall in eastern Australia is typically below average during spring, and daytime temperatures are generally warmer than average for southern Australia. Turning to the August to October rainfall outlook, below average rainfall is likely for much of mainland Australia, most notably in the southeast. August in particular is likely to bring a drier end to winter. What does this mean for the streamflow outlook? With dry soils and below average rainfall likely, low flows are expected at more than 2/3 of forecast locations for July to September. In terms of temperatures, warmer than average days and nights are likely for much of the country. It's now fire season in the north. The Northern Australian seasonal bushfire outlook shows much of the area across Northern Australia has normal fire potential. In the northwest, areas with above normal fire potential are linked to strong vegetation growth following above average rainfall in the last wet season. In the south, recent drier and warmer conditions may see more areas with increased fire potential when the official southern seasonal bushfire outlook is released in the coming months. More details are available on the Bushfire and Natural Hazards CRC website. So in summary, August to October is likely to be drier than average for much of mainland Australia. Temperatures are likely to be higher than average, with low streamflows likely at most locations. Our ENSO outlook remains at El Niño watch. For more details, visit our website at bom.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also get updates via Facebook and Twitter. Our first look at likely conditions for spring will be available on Thursday, the 16th of August. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Felicity Gamble.